Hi students, from today I am going to start unit 3, that is elementary combinatorics. So the unit 3 is elementary combinatorics. First of all, the first topic in this unit is basics of counting. So there are two basic rules of counting. They are number one is sum rule and number two is product rule. So now we define what is the sum rule and what is the product rule. Number one, sum rule. What is the definition of a sum rule? Suppose the two tasks, one is T1 and other one is T2. So two tasks are T1 and T2 are to be performed one after the other. Then T1 is performed in m different ways and T2 is performed in n different ways. So the task T1 is performed in m different ways and the task T2 is performed in n different ways. So by sum rule, then the total number of ways of performing two tasks is m plus n different ways. So by the help of a sum rule means, already we know that sum means plus. Sum means plus. So the total number of ways in performing the two tasks is m plus n different ways. Sum means we can easily identify that sum means plus. So m plus n different ways. Now we see some of the examples. Suppose a library has 12 books on mathematics, 10 books on physics, 16 books on computer science, 11 books on electronics. Then by using sum rule, we can solve this problem. Suppose a student wishes to choose one of the books for study, then the number of ways he can choose is, how many ways he can choose? That is 12 plus 10 plus 16 plus 11, that is equal to 49 ways. So the student can wish to choose in 49 ways. This is with the help of a sum rule. Next, another problem. We see another problem. This product rule. Number two is product rule. It is also product means, we already know that product means it is multiplication. The product rule says that, same as the sum rule, suppose the two tasks, one is T1 and another one is T2, are to be performed one after the other. Then T1 is performed in m ways and T2 is performed in n ways. Then the both these tasks can be performed in m into n different ways. Already we know that the product means into multiplication. So these tasks can be performed in m into n different ways. By the sum rule means it is addition. We have to sum there, do the sum there. Next, product means we have to multiply there. Already we know that sum means plus and product means multiplication. So this is an example. Suppose a person has 3 shirts and 5 trousers, then he has how many different ways to choosing a shirt and a trouser? So this is the problem. So a person has, he has a 3 shirts and 5 trousers, then he has to choose how many different ways he has to choose a shirt and a trouser. So by using the product rule, simply we can say that 3 into 5, that is equal to 15 different ways. So he can choose in 15 different ways of choosing a shirt and a trouser. So by the help of a product rule, easily we can solve these problems. Next problem is, a man can spend his evening in one of the following ways. So a man has some of the following ways. He can do the shopping, or he can go to cinema hall, or he can go to restaurant. So if there are 6 shopping complexes, he is going to spend his evening at 6 shopping complexes are there, and 8 cinema halls are there, and 9 restaurants are there. Then the question he was asked was, how many different ways he can spend his evening? So by the help of a sum rule, easily we can say that the 6 plus 8 plus 9, that is 23 different ways. So in the 23 different ways, he can spend his evening. So by the help of a sum rule, easily we can solve this type of problems. If two distinguishable dice are thrown, already we know about the dice. When a die is rolled n times, then we have a formula of 6 power n. Now, when a die is rolled 2 times, what is the formula? 2 times means the formula is 6 square, that is equal to 36 times. So, when a die is rolled 2 times, then we have 6 square, that is equal to 36 elements. Then, he has asked, how many ways can we get a sum of 4 or 8? Next, another one is, how many ways we get a sum of 8? So, we already know that his die was rolled 2 times means 6 square, that is equal to 36 elements. So there are 3 ways to get a sum of 4. 3 ways means 1 plus 3, that is 4, 2 plus 2, that is 4, 3 plus 1, that is 4. So there are only three ways we get a sum of 4. See, we have to see these values in only our 6 power n, 6 square, 36 elements only we have to check these values. Already we know that the 36 elements are 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, 1, 6 and so on up to 6, 6. So 36 elements. So we have to choose these values in only that 36 elements only. So there are three ways of getting a sum of 4. So 1 comma 3, that is 1 plus 3, 4. 2 plus 2, that is 4. 3 plus 1, that is 4. Likewise, another one is, there are 5 ways to get a sum of 8. He has asked, what is the sum of 8? So there are 5 ways. That is, 2 plus 6, that equal to 8. 3 plus 5, that equal to 8. 4 plus 4, that equal to 8. 5 plus 3, that equal to 8. And 6 plus 2, that equal to 8. So the total ways of getting a sum of 8 is 5. So now, by the number of ways to get a sum is of 4 or 8. Here sum means we have to put in a mind that sum means or, product means end we can take, sum means or. So 4 or 8 is, this is the 3 ways plus this is the 5 ways, that equal to 8 ways. So number of ways to get a sum of 4 or 8 is 8 ways. So this is the answer for the given question. Now another question is, how many ways we get an even sum? So even sum. So there are, in that we have to check how many values are there in that when a die is rolled 2 times. We already know 6 square equal to, that equal to 36 elements. So in that 36 elements only we have to choose the elements. So here the number of ways we get an even sum means the number of ways to get the even of even numbers means here we are having 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 or 12. So up to 12 only. Why? Because last element 6 comma 6. 6 comma 6 means 12. So 2, 4, 6, 8, 12, 10 and 12 are the even number. So on good, getting them, 2 means 1, 4 means 3, 6 means 5, 8 means 5, and 10 means 3, and 12 means 1 ways. So the total ways is 18 ways. So this is the solution for the given problem. Next, another problem. If two distinguishable dice are thrown, if he asked about the dice, then simply we can say that the formula for a die is 6 power n. He has said that two distinguishable dice, 2 means 6 square, that equal to 36 elements. In how many ways can they fall? So simple answer is this, it will fall in 6 square, that equal to 36. Here we are using a product rule. That is, the first die can be fall in 6 ways, the second die can be fall in 6 ways. So by product rule, 6 into 6, that equal to 36. So 36 ways they can fall. Next one is, if 5 distinguishable dice are thrown. 5, he has said about the 5. We know that the formula for dice is 6 power n, where n is number of times. So 5 distinguishable dice are rolled. So 6 power 5, that is 6 into 6 into 6 into 5 times. Now he has asked how many possible outcomes are there. So the answer for this is 6 into 6 into 6 whole power 5, that equal to 6 power 5. 6 power elements 5 is the answer for the given solution. So we have to put in mind that the formula for when a die is rolled n times is 6 power n. We see another. Here next problem is, a man wants to spend his evening in the following way. First he would like to go for a shopping. Then he would like to go for a cinema hall. And finally he would like to go to a restaurant. Then if there are 6 shopping complexes, already we have done this problem in the previous. If there are 6 shopping complexes, 8 cinema halls and 9 restaurants, then he has asked how many different ways can he spend his evening. So the simple answer is 6 into 8 into 9, that equal to 6 into 8 into 9 is 432 ways. So the answer for the given problem is simply by using of a product rule, simply we can say that 6 into 8 into 9, that equal to 432 ways is the answer for the given problem. So next he has given another problem. How many 3-digit numbers can be formed using the digits? He has asked 3-digit numbers and he has given the digits 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8 and 9. So he has asked the question that how many 3 digits can be formed by using these digits. So here each of the 3 digits can be filled in 7 ways. So you are having 3 digits and we are having 7. So it can be filled in 7 ways. So by the help of a product rule, we can simply say that the required number of 3 digits can be 7 into 7 into 7, that equal to 343 ways. So the solution is 343 ways. Why? Because 3 digits are there, total number of sum is 7 digits are there. So 7 into 7 into 7, that equal to 343. So here he has given another problem. How many three digit numbers can be formed if no digits can be repeated? Here repetition is not allowed. See, here repetition is allowed and here repetition is not allowed. So if the repetition are not allowed, the required number of three digits number can be, here we have to come from back, 7 into 6 into 5. Since we are having three digits, 7 into 6 into 5, that equal to 210 ways. Here it is repeated, here it is not repeated. If it is repeated and the three digits, then the total digits are 7, then 7 into 7 into 7, that equal to 343. Here repetitions are not allowed, then we have the solution of 7 into 6 into 5, that equal to 210. So this is the solution for the given problem. Next, how many different license plates are there that involve 1, 2, 3 letters formed by 4 digits? So already we know that English alphabets have 26 letters. So the number of plates with one letter followed by 4 digits is 26 into 10 power 4. So the number of plates of two letters formed by 4 digits, that is 26 square into 10 power 4. So the number of plates of three digits, three letters followed by 4 digits is 26 whole cube into 10 power 4. So they are all are mutually exclusive. We already know that mutually exclusive or disjoint means no common element in between them. So by the help of a sum rule, we can easily solve this problem. So if we do the sum of this, we get the required solution, and this is the required solution for the given problem. So this is about the basics of counting, about the sum rule and product rule, and these are the sum of the problems on basics of counting.